Para business leaders dan intellectual business community, kita lanjutkan dalam segmen berikutnya tentang Is Yours a Learning Organizations? Kita akan membahas tentang learning organizations, dan kita ada di sini narasumber kita Jens Reis, adalah CEO dari Allianz Indonesia. Okay, let's continue, Jens. When you announced that you want Allianz Indonesia to be a learning organizations, what were the reactions of your people? Are they happy or are they skeptics? Or they, what was the reaction?
I think if you share the idea, I think the first sharing will be positive. This is, I think, clear. Uh-huh. The second thinking is, of course, from the concern of managers and employees is, well, whatever we do, but does our leader follow? Does my boss follow? Uh-huh. So in this case, it was, I think, very, very clear. In order to make this a success, we have to start from top. It must start from myself, from all the management team. We have to commit, and I think the first thing what we have changed is we have around 220 working days, mm-hmm. and we said that we have to have a certain days, number of days, depending on the level where you are in the company, where you have to commit and share learning to the Allianz community. So in this case, an example, a manager today should share 10 days in training, in learning, within the umbrella of the Allianz Indonesia Corporate University to the stakeholders in the area where he or she is familiar and can contribute. So I think we have done, I think that was one major change. The second major change is, of course, that the leaders must do training and must require also from their managers and also from employees training. We have the determined philosophy that maybe for the start you need external training partners. Yes, uh-huh. of course. No, we will not be good and the heroes in everything. No? But important for us is that we gradually adapt knowledge and that our own people are able to contribute and are able to deliver training and to work with our own agents or employees. So to give a good example, we use an external training partner now, very big, for a service program. But our service program is designed that we are relatively fast training trainers, uh-huh. and then at the end that our own employees training our own employees, that uh-huh. we are creating service champions. And we have a logo. The logo is like the Allianz Indonesia Corporate University today. So we have created the title of learning champions. So people, managers or agents who are contributing to the Allianz community will be recognized with learning champion title, right. and will carry the logo of the Allianz Corporate uh-huh. University on their name card. Uh-huh. So we are running basically like it's an Allianz community work with a determined goal to have a learning organization.
I see. Yeah. So what is your vision? You said within 3 years you want Allianz to be a learning organization. What is your vision the next 3 years? How would the Allianz will be? How would the people behave?
Well, we want engagement from all levels, and we want that everybody thinks, and we are guiding this process, where he or she can contribute to the organization.
And it is self-running?
It is, of course, we are guiding the process. Right. So we have basically in our Allianz Corporate University, one big half is related to the major stakeholders we have. We have agencies today in our business, we have bank assurance today in our business, and we have employees or leadership and service. On the other side, we have a lot on curriculum development, on communication, on appreciation, on train-the-trainer programs. So this is basically, I think, the other, so to say, coordinating umbrella. And both of that is now integrated. You can imagine that it's a major change, at least for Allianz, where traditionally you have training for employees, uh-huh. you have training for different sales channels. Now we made the decision, we combine all under one umbrella. This is not free of any discussion and not uh-huh. free of critics. Ne? So it takes a lot of, I think, discussions and convincement, but at the end, I think we today have a buy-in and people see the value. We have, with this umbrella, we want to create a better competency development. We want to create a change management capability. I think we truly believe that if people train and if people, I think, share, they will be also more convinced and they will be automatically, I think, also better knowledgeable among themselves. No? So this is, I think, a few elements.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. So from this article, we learn that to build a learning organization, there are three building blocks that we have to make sure that this learning organization dream will come true. First is that a supportive learning environment where people are free to give and express their ideas, thinking without being afraid of being suppressed by the superiors or whatever. And then second is the concrete learning process and practice. I mean, we have to also install a system that automatically all people share their knowledge together, provide the opportunity, provide also the system, yeah, to, you know, to generate, to keep and to distribute the knowledge to all the members. Yeah. And the third of the learning block is that the leadership behavior that reinforce the learning. Hmm. So the leaders are important also to push in every side so that everybody learns. Hmm. Yeah. So far, how far you see Allianz has fulfilled these three building blocks?
Well, I would like we are say we are ready for all three. Ne? Uh-huh. I think we have started the change process, and it is a big change process. I think every organization which makes itself the goal of an integrated learning organization, there is an element of time and culture building. Uh-huh. You like it or not, but you have to go through that. And I think from the three building blocks you mentioned, I think the key ones are number one and number three. We have to get the environment that people are free, open, yes, and positive in learning, in sharing. And we have the leaders who not only have to demand it, but do it.
Right.
So in this case, I think all of us in all levels, I'm sure that even a person who is maybe introverted and a person who is extroverted, take the introverted one, must have some capability where sharing is very valuable for the organization. In your introduction in the beginning, you mentioned it. I think today we must by all means create the environment that knowledge is also kept within our workforce in our company.
Right.
So even we have, of course, sometimes key people leaving, we have, of course, also a fluctuation. I think this must be seen as healthy, and it's also a challenge every day if our learning and our sharing community is working or not.
No? Right, yeah. Okay. So I think some of the audience here wants to ask questions or give comments. Please, I open to the floor. Pak Bunadi, you want to ask something?
Saya observe beberapa tahun yang lalu, kita tahu bahwa di Indonesia itu juga ada suatu multinational sebagai learning organization.
Sebut aja Pak, apa-apa Pak.
Barangkali Citibank, IBM, ya pada saat itu, 10 atau 20 tahun yang lalu. Kemudian saya lihat dari local company juga ada, seperti misalnya Astra, uh-huh, itu juga banyak menerapkan ini. Programnya adalah bahwa walaupun sudah ada suatu three building blocks dalam learning organization seperti yang disebutkan di sini, tetapi tetap saja karyawan itu banyak yang pindah ke perusahaan lain. Uh-huh. Tetapi bagi Citibank, bagi IBM, bagi Astra, bagi mereka nggak apa-apa, karena proses secara continuous itu ada dan tetap ada pengganti yang lain. Dan dimanapun mereka berada, mereka merasa bahwa mereka itu masih mempunyai pikiran bahwa mereka pernah di-train di organization itu. Pertanyaan saya sekarang, kita sering juga melihat bahwa ada suatu tren. Banyak entrepreneurs mencoba juga membentuk university seperti Trump University, dari Allianz University yang disebutkan tadi, dan juga banyak university-university yang lain, atau bahkan juga banyak yang mencantumkan nama perusahaannya sehingga nama business school itu adalah nama perusahaannya. Nah, pertanyaan saya, apakah sudah cukup dengan building block ini bisa maintain karyawan tetap stay, karena perkembangan sekarang seperti di China, mereka banyak sekali belajar di perusahaan multinasional, kemudian mereka pindah mereka kerja di perusahaan lokal, karena perusahaan multinasional itu banyak memberikan suatu apa namanya supportive learning environment, tetapi akhirnya mereka pindah juga.
Oke, okay, Pak Bernardi, thank you for the questions. Saya kira jelas di sini ya bahwa apa yang bisa membuat karyawan itu tidak pindah, kita sudah bahas waktu episode kedua di Talent Management of the 21st Century. Justru di dalam artikel hari ini kita talking about learning organization, Pak. We are not talking specifically bahwa pegawai itu tidak boleh pindah, or this act membuat karyawan tidak pindah, karena ini tidak berkaitan langsung. Bisa juga karyawan menjadi tidak mau pindah karena dia tahu dia akan learning terus di sini. Tetapi juga bisa juga karena dia udah learning terus di sini, menganggap bahwa nanti saya di perusahaan lain dibayar lebih mahal, jadi dia bisa pindah. The key here is that di dalam learning organizations, walaupun seseorang itu pindah, apa yang sudah dipelajari itu tetap stay di organisasi. Kenapa itu bisa stay di organisasi? Karena ada satu sistem knowledge management di mana apa yang dia pelajari, apa experience-nya itu harus dia share, harus dia keep record-nya, sehingga setiap saat perusahaan itu perlu apa yang sudah dia dapatkan experience maupun knowledge-nya itu bisa diakses. Ya, jadi they don't keep it for themselves, tapi they have to make copies in the head of the people or in the system of the organizations. Justru silakan you pindah, tapi apa yang sudah you pelajari dan knowledge yang sudah pelajari di sini will stay here gitu, Pak. Ya, jadi tetapi again we can also see whether this is the aim of the alliance untuk supaya orang itu enggak pindah dengan membuat learning organization di alliance. Tapi kita harus menyudahi seksi ini dulu untuk kita masuk ke seksi berikutnya. Jadi buat para business leaders dan intellectual business community yang ingin beraktivitas, ingin memberikan komentar, memberikan saran ataupun pendapat, bisa SMS ke 08 999 999 788, 08 966 788, dan buat yang terpilih akan mendapatkan buku dari Harvard Business Press berjudul Talent on Demand. Kita akan masuk ke dalam seksi berikutnya.